Can you make money from your passion? So that's what I'm going to talk about in this video. The answer is, in my opinion, yes, you can make money from your passions if enough other people share the same passion and if you pay attention to what they're paying for in regards to that passion. And before I go on, my cat has just jumped up here. This is Mango. He always seems to jump up. I sit here all the time doing my work, but he only jumps up when I'm recording something. It's the strangest thing. So anyway, because he likes the limelight, so I better adjust my camera so that you can see him a little better. So in the building of an authentic business, there are, I'd say, two focuses, and I want you to think about this and think about whether which focus you have. There's passion. And then there's compassion. Okay, so check this out. Passion is whatever you're excited by, you're energized by, you are, maybe you studied a particular modality, maybe you have had a particular peak experience and you want to kind of lead everybody toward the same kind of peak experience you've had. Or you have a particular problem you solved in your life, and you think, gosh, you know what? If I could help other people solve this problem, wouldn't that be great? Okay. So that's your passion. That's your passion, right? Because it's from your own experience. It's from your own head, from your own life, right? From your own problems and your dreams. Okay. The other focus is compassion. Now, when I say compassion, I don't mean that if you're focused on your passion, you're not a compassionate person. That's not what I mean. I'm talking about how these energies lead into your product. Okay. So if you build a product based on your passion, then you've built a product based on your passion, not necessarily other people's passions. That's the problem with passion, is that it's so easy to become, well, actually, it's true, both passion and compassion can blind you. Okay, so has your passion blinded you to what the market actually wants? And you'll know the answer if you're trying to sell your passion and nobody is buying it. Then you've had your passion has blinded you, because remember, you make money when other people spend money on your stuff. Where does money come from? Money doesn't come from, oh, I'm so enthusiastic about this, I'm so passionate about this, but you're not buying it. Oh, but I'm so passionate about it. But I'm not, the other person says, oh, okay, cool. I'm grateful for your passion and I'm happy for you, but I'm not willing to spend money on it. It's not something that I really can see myself spending money on. I mean, I'm happy for you, right? So that's the problem with passion, is it can blind us. Of course, compassion can blind us too, because we get lost in solving other people's problems, and then we kind of lose our own soul along the way. So an authentic business is kind of this intersection of passion and compassion. So let me talk about compassion. So we talked about a product based off of your passion can be blinded because other people aren't spending money on it. Okay. Now let's talk about a product based on compassion, focused compassion. Everybody watching this is a nice person. You probably love helping other people, et cetera, et cetera. I tend to draw people like you into my audience. I'd like to think that I'm the same way. But can your compassion be focused enough to create a product from it? Not just, oh, I just like helping other people. People ask for help. I'm off to help them out. Wonderful. That's actually a you're a winner in life. Okay? That's really, I think, what spirituality and life is about. But in business, that compassion needs to be channeled into a product. Okay, it need into channeled into a program, a service, an event that you charge for, or whatever it is you charge for. So, have you done that? Have you focused your compassion to say, oh, that's interesting. I've talked to, 10, 20 people this month, and five of them told me that they are really struggling with problem A, and they struggle with problem A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and I am really excited to help people solve problem G or problem A. Great. Now, can I create a product or a service or a book or an online course or a package or an event that I can charge for based on problem G. If I create a product based on my focused compassion for other people, because I have talked to them, I know that they're dealing with it, I know they're frustrated by it, I know they're looking to get help for it, and if I create a product from it and then I offer it to them, obviously they're going to buy because they like me, they notice I'm compassionate, I'm trying to help them out, and I've created something that they actually want, of course they're going to buy. And that's how business becomes viable, right? So now, let's try to merge passion and compassion, okay? And actually, before I go there, I just want to say, this is why the term empathy has become more and more popular nowadays in entrepreneurship. That's what they mean, okay? Empathy, people go, wait, but I'm such an empathetic person, I help everybody, but I make no money. Okay, so that's why I'm doing this video, is to say it's not just empathy. Empathy is great for spiritual growth and wonderful. That's what, you know, all the saints have taught us. You know, we need to be empathetic and help other people. One of my heroes is Peace Pilgrim. If you've never heard of Peace Pilgrim, please look her up and read her book, Steps Towards Inner Peace. It changed my life. But Peace Pilgrim made no money. Actually, she very purposely didn't want to take any money for all the help she gave. She was a pilgrim. She was homeless. She just walked. Funny story about it is that she finally died in a car accident when someone drove her from one place to another. But she walked for 30, 40 years all across America, just helping wherever she saw people. And she just kept walking until people fed her and sheltered her. I mean, it's a truly inspirational story. Not just did it for 3-month experiment, put on viral video on YouTube. She did it for 30 years. Okay. Anyway, one of my heroes for sure. I am not called to be homeless and be a peace pilgrim. And probably you're not either, I'm guessing. That's why you're watching this. Otherwise, you wouldn't have a computer to watch this. So if you are called to live a householder life, right? Meaning, you know, being in society, you know, helping others within the system of commerce, then you need to monetize your empathy. I know that sounds terrible, but monetize some of your empathy, okay, so that you can keep doing that thing and getting better and better at it as your day job, right? That's what I do. I love helping people with their business and with their marketing. And yes, I probably would do it for free, but then I would be working in a corporate job and not doing this as my day job. But right now it's, you know, during the day I'm here at home, you know, doing this work because people pay me for some of my work. I do a lot of this stuff for free. As you can tell, I love doing this stuff. I do my videos for free, write my blog posts. I spend a lot of time doing free work because I enjoy doing it, but I am uncompromising when it comes to charging for some of it. When it comes to one-to-one work with me, right? Like you're taking one person taking my time. I'm saying, no, you got to pay me for it. So you got to be uncompromised. You got to be strict about charging for certain things that are not scalable. Like this, a bunch of you are watching this right now. I'm happy to just give it away for free. But if you want my help one-to-one, you can comment and I'll do some free work replying to your comments. But if you try to get in depth with me to say, George, please give me feedback on my webpage. I'm like, sorry, I can't help one person for free. Otherwise, I'm out of my business. I'm going to a corporate job. I can't help you one person for free. I can help a lot of you for free, you know, if it just takes me 1 hour of my time or whatever. But you see, just like me, you got to be uncompromising when it comes to charging for certain things that are not scalable. All right, same thing. I have a group program, just 40 people, no more than 40 people, and I can't help them for free because, sorry about that, my phone. That's the problem with doing live videos, right? Just things happen like this. I can't help 40 people many hours a week for free because otherwise, you know, I'd run out of energy, I'd be in a corporate job, and I can't do any of these videos anymore. So how about you? Are you willing to be uncompromising when it comes to monetizing some of your empathy, some of your compassion in a focused way based on what other people want, what other people are struggling with in their life, okay? What goals they are just yearning to reach, okay? And for the rest of it, the rest of your compassion and empathy and passion, give as much for free as you can. Okay. Another example in my business is I have three offerings, right? I have the one-to-one, which is full, by the way. I'm grateful for that. I have a waiting list. One-to-one coaching, uncompromising. I charge for it. Even though my clients, I would probably help them for free. I know some of you are watching this. George, help me for free. I can't, right? Otherwise, I'll be out of my business. So one-to-one, I have to charge for, because otherwise, you know, I have no business. Group, small group, well, up to 40 people, right, in a group, I have to charge for that. And then my workshops, my trainings, my courses that I put together, that I put a lot of hours into creating a structured online course. To be honest, it's not my favorite thing to do. I don't really love creating my online courses. I like it okay, and I can see it helps you. That's why I do it, and I charge for it. I charge you money. You got to pay me $60 for my newest online course about enrolling clients. Because if it was just up to me, I probably wouldn't do it for free. It's just not, I mean, I know it helps you. And once I do it, I'm glad I did it. You know, kind of like working out, right? It's like, I don't really go want to work out. But once I do it, I'm glad. So I know it's good for the world. It's good for me, you know, in some larger professional sense. Probably wouldn't do it for free. So some of my compassion is not, so in other words, I've got passion and compassion. Some of my compassion, I don't really, it's not my, not really my passion. I wouldn't do it for free. But I know that helps you, so that's why I do it, and you've got to pay me money for it. That's why I still am motivated to do it, and I still do it as a day job. So that's my question for you in this video is, can you, are you willing to separate your passion from your compassion, your passion, stuff you do for free anyway? Do as much for free as you can, helping as many people as you can, which builds your audience. But then you've got to look at your compassion to say, am I willing to talk with my audience on an individual basis and say, ah, you know, Ruth, what is it you're wanting, and what is it you're paying for right now? Can I create the same thing and you pay me instead of paying this other person who doesn't care as much about you maybe? I care about you, right? You know, Teo Kai, Ming, can I, you know, I'm looking at the people who've joined my life called Swapna. You're paying for other people to do this? Can you pay me instead? Because I'm going to create something that you're paying other people to do, except I'll try to create it more for you, you know, get to know you better, create, customize it more for you, and you can pay me for it so I can stay in my business and help a bunch of people for free, and you'll know that you're contributing to that too. You know what I mean? So separate your passion and compassion. Charge for some of your compassion, but that's what people are paying you for, is paying you for your focused, monetized compassion turn into a product or service. And your passion, you know what? I'll end with this. Even here's the thing. To make money faster, you need to do focused compassion monetized into a product or service. That's how you make money faster. You can make money with your passion. Okay? You can. But it'll take you a couple years probably, because you have to just educate the whole world about what you love and kind of change people's minds and get them to really think like the way you think. And that's a lot of work, right? Like I've been doing this for 10 years, and now I've maybe educated some of you into believing in authentic business and authentic marketing. And now you're like, well, yeah, I want to pay George for authentic business, authentic marketing, which I never thought about before George. And now I'm interested in it. And now I'm maybe willing to pay for it. But see, that's my passion. It took me years to start to monetize that. But I still make more money monetizing my compassion, my focused product-led compassion. And then let's talk about how to integrate the two. I integrate the two by bringing some of my passion flavor into my compassion, my monetized focused compassion work. Does that make sense? Meaning, I sell you a workshop on how to get more clients. It's not my passion. It's not, if I were totally financially independent, I probably wouldn't be doing workshops on how to get more clients. It's not my passion, but I know it helps you and I'm kind of good at it. So I'm going to do that as my compassion work, but I flavor that with my passion work by bringing in my passion of authentic business, authentic marketing, being honest, being blah, 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 blah. You see? But you don't pay me because I'm honest. You don't pay me because I'm spiritual. You don't pay me for my spiritual talk. Trust me, none of you are paying me for that. Okay. You enjoy when I talk about it, but you're not taking money out of your wallet. George, I love your spiritual talk. I'm going to pay you for it. I'm not a pastor, even though some people call me an internet business pastor, right? But I don't have a church. I'm not taking tithe. But I flavor my spirituality into my compassion-led work that I wouldn't probably do for free. You see, so that's what makes my work fun. It's like, yeah, I'm not grudgingly doing my workshops. I do it because I know it helps you. So that kind of helps, that kind of incentivizes me a bit. I'm getting paid for it. That certainly keeps me in business. And I get to bring some of my passion into it, my spirituality, my values, my cat, you know, my dog or whatever. You know. So I hope this is helpful. Think about what that is for you. Draw two circles, your passions, and then what is, you know, on one side, and the other side is your compassion. When you talk to people, what problems do they have that you can definitely solve? You have the talent for it. And then can try to merge the two. It's like, can you kind of bring some of your passion stuff, flavor your season, your compassion-led, productized work with some of your passion. And then you have an authentic business, the more you can merge the two. So I hope that helps, and wishing you a wonderful rest of your day. And thanks for those who are joining me here, Jill and Susan, Swapna, Stephanie, Reza, Judith, Tio. Thank you so much. And I look forward to your comments. Be well.